Alright guys, welcome back to the another video. In this video I'm going to show you how to download the SPOT5 satellite imagery from internet, and also in the later video I'll show you like how to orthorectify that image and then how to generate the DEM using two stereo pair of imagery. So this is the DEM generated from stereo pair processing. So if you want to know how did I generate this DEM, then watch this playlist till the end. So let's get started. If you don't know about SPOT satellite imagery, then I highly recommend you to check this blog post in GIS Geography. It has the really nice description from like SPOT 1 to SPOT 7 satellite, and then it has also like written the information what are the available bands. For example, in SPOT 1 to 3, it has only 3 band: green, red and near infrared. In SPOT 5 also similar but slightly different, and in SPOT 5 it has green, red, near infrared and shortwave infrared, but the resolution is 10 meter and then the 20 meter for SWIR. And also this blog post contain the like information about from when they have launched this mission until what date we can get that data set. For example, for the SPOT 5, it was launched in 2002 and then it's still remain in the orbit. And for the SPOT 5, 6 and 7, I think those are for the commercial purpose and we cannot get the data freely. Alright, so yeah, in order to download the data set, so you need to type SWS data site, and then you launch into the first link, which is SWS data center, and then just click on that link, and it might take to load take time to load fully this website. And this SWS mean SPOT World Heritage, and you can click whenever you wherever you want, and simply it will take time to load the OSM background map. And from here you can easily like download the required data and then select the required product. For example, is I'm interested in somewhere maybe this region near Butawal, then I simply need to like draw the area of interest, and then it will automatically search the imagery for that particular area of interest and then give me the result. And yeah, you can see it here, there are so many satellite imagery, so many layers available here. In order to filter that out, so I can simply match the coupling mode to stereo because I'm interested to generate the DEM. That's what product we need for the DEM generation. Of course, we need SPOT 5 imagery, and maybe I'll leave the sensor and instrument blank and then select the date. As I remember, the product is available from 2002 to 2010. So by default, I have this date. But if I want the product between like 2002 to 2004, then I can simply select this and then hit search. And yeah, now my product are filtered out and then it has less imagery, right? And now the other thing you can do is you can sort based on date. It will be like a little bit easier to like scroll this imagery. So these are the bounding box of the particular right side imagery. So here you can see cloud free is 74.96. Try to find whatever image has the highest cloud free percentage, and then you can generate the DEM. Also, maybe you can generate the DEM based on the season. For example, this is from February and then this is from March. And yeah, feel free to select any date. For example, I'm a little bit interested in the later month, which is around, I think, maybe this one. So the date of this image acquisition is 11/16/2003, 5:15. And then what about this one? 11/16/2003, 5:17. So looks like these two are the stereo pair. But before like start downloading, I have this download button is disabled. So you might need to log in with your user account, and then your download button will be activated. And yeah, somehow our map doesn't look great, but that's okay. So we can simply use this setting. Okay, maybe I'll download this stereo product. Feel free to download any 10, 11, but before downloading you need to verify that both are from same date and around approximately same time, so that you can generate the stereo pair, right? And then the bounding box is right here, right? And this one is also the similar. So I'll simply download these products, and then I'll pause for a minute, and then I'll unpause this video whenever it complete. All right, so now the imagery are downloaded successfully. So now I can extract these and then visualize it in any GIS softwares. So yeah, so now these are the two imagery so far I have, and inside it I have this scene 01 and then the imagery.tiff. And then if I try to visualize it, so you'll see the same product. It's the grayscale imagery, and then it is 10 meter resolution. You can see the features a little bit blurry, and of course the other thing is like this is not orthorectified imagery. We'll orthorectify this using stereo pair processing, and then after that we'll create the dam based on this and then the other imagery. So let me load both. Where is it? Okay, and then one, scene one, and then imagery. Okay, actually both look the same because both are like captured on the same date, same time, but with the two different camera. Maybe one is from left and one is from right, and that's why the image is also not orthorectified. And yeah, so if you talk about like metadata, so metadata are stored in metadata.dim file, and then if you open it, it's simply the XML file. It has its extent and then its value representation and so many things. I also haven't like explored what are all these metadata things. You also don't need to know what are the things inside metadata. So those metadata we are going to use this metadata file and then the imagery file to process the stereo pair. Okay, so yeah, that's all about like how to assess the SPOT5 satellite imagery, and I hope you enjoyed this video. And then if you enjoy it, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in the next one. Thank you for watching.